This is Casey Kasem on AT40 in Hollywood, and we're up to the third of this week's debut songs. It's the first top 40 hit by a six-man group from Los Angeles who call themselves Toto. Their song is Hold the Line. Toto at number 37, first week on the chart with Hold the Line.
Number 37.
The song we heard at number 38 was by a band of three brothers, the Gap Band. Well, here's another group that features three brothers, Jeff, Mike, and Steve Porcaro. Together with David Paich, Bobby Kimball, and Steve Lukather, they formed the band Toto, debuting at number 37 this week with Make Believe, Toto. Their last hit, Rosanna, got all the way to number 2. Their current hit comes in at number 37 on American Top 40. It's Make Believe by Toto. I'm Lee Sherwood, sitting in for Casey Kasem.
This is American Top 40 in Hollywood. I'm Casey Kasem, and our worldwide presentation of the 100 most popular songs of the year continues. Now, here's the Grammy Award-winning band made up of men who have said they make more money as session musicians than they do as a group. Several members of this band are on Michael Jackson's sensational album, Thrill It, but they also make hit records when they record in their own, like this number one song that comes in at number 26 in our end-of-the-year survey, Africa, the group Toto. Number 26 among the year's most successful songs, that's Africa by Toto. Now on American Top 40, we're up to the latest hit by the band Toto. The band, whose drummer Jeff Porcaro says, has made a bigger contribution to pop music than any other group. That sounds boastful, but let's put it in context. The members of Toto, before they banded together, were all high-paid session musicians. That went on for a number of years before they organized as Toto in 1978. And they've never stopped working as session players on other artists' records. They've backed Boz Scaggs on most of his albums. They did Olivia Newton-John's huge hit album, Physical, and both of Christopher Cross's albums. And most of the musicians you hear behind Michael Jackson on his smash LP Thriller are the members of Toto. Jeff Porcaro's exact quote in People magazine was this: "I don't mean to blow our horn too loudly, but individually and collectively, we've made a bigger contribution than any other bunch of musicians in pop. We played on literally thousands of albums." That's Jeff Porcaro speaking with understandable pride about his group Toto. They had just won 5 Grammys. Among those thousands of albums Toto members have played on are 4 that they've made for themselves. The most recent, called Toto 4, generated 3 singles in 1982, Rosanna, Make Believe, and Africa. And they're on the charts currently with a 4th song from that same album, I Won't Hold You Back. Up 7 notches this week to number 28, here are the super musicians, Toto.
If I had another chance, that we had just can't be found.
Toto with their 4th top 40 hit from the LP Toto 4. Moving from 35 to 28 in our survey this week, I Won't Hold You Back.
American Top 40.
Now on American Top 40, we're up to the band that's hired a new singer, the band Toto. Their new singer is Joe Williams. Joe's father is a famous composer and conductor who wrote this chilling theme. The theme from the Oscar-winning score of the movie Jaws. Now the same man wrote this. The Force be with you. The Oscar-winning music from the movie Star Wars, composed and conducted by a man who's won 4 Academy Awards for his work on film scores, the talented John Williams. And there's more musical talent in the Williams family. John's 25-year-old son, Joe. He's sung backup on concert tours for artists like Jeffrey Osborne, has done studio work singing on television commercials. Now he's been drafted by the band Toto as their new lead vocalist. Joe Williams is making his top 40 debut on Toto's latest hit, but he doesn't sing the lead vocal on this particular song. Guitarist Steve Lukather does. At number 22, here's Toto, I'll Be Over You.
Some people live their dreams.
that was formed in 1978 in Los Angeles. Their eighth top 40 hit is I'll Be Over You from the album Fahrenheit. You're listening to American Top 40. My name's Casey Kasem. This is our special survey of the 40 biggest recording acts on the Billboard singles chart so far in this decade. Number one in the 50s, by the way, was Elvis Presley. Number one in the 60s, the Beatles. Number one in the 70s were the Bee Gees. And who's number one so far in the 80s? Well, that's what we're going to find out. We're up to number 30, and on we go.
Number 30!
This next group of musicians were making good livings in Los Angeles just playing backup on other people's records. Then a hit they had in the late 70s called Hold the Line gave them a taste of what it was like performing on their own hit records. So they went after the big money. And in the 80s, they've hit with 99, Rosanna, Make Believe, Africa, and I Won't Hold You Back. Several months ago, they won 6 Grammys, and they're the 30th biggest act of the 1980s so far. Here's Toto. Those are the 6 men of Toto with Rosanna, one of the 5 hit songs that landed them at number 30 among the 40 top acts of the 1980s so far.
American Top 40.
Well, now we're up to the band Toto. And the truth behind The Wizard of Oz. Now, we all know about that children's book and about the movie, about a girl from Kansas who, with her faithful dog Toto, ends up over the rainbow, right? Well, that only scratches the surface. The Wizard of Oz is actually an allegory for the American populist movement of the 1890s, at least according to some literary scholars. Now, we found this interpretation in a 1964 volume of a magazine called The American Quarterly. And it says the character Dorothy represents what the Populist Party stood for at the time. The little guy, the American everyman. The Scarecrow was the Midwest farmer. The Tin Man, the working man, dehumanized by the Industrial Revolution. The Cowardly Lion, who really was courageous, represents a politician, William Jennings Bryant, a pacifist who ran for president as a populist candidate in 1896. The Yellow Brick Road, that represents the gold standard. You see, the populace wanted to do away with it. They wanted to base the economy on silver. In fact, Dorothy's slippers in the book were silver, not the ruby slippers of the movie. Now, the Emerald City was Washington, D.C. The wizard himself was the President of the United States, who seemed great and powerful, but was just an ordinary man. The Wicked Witch of the West represented the destructive forces of nature in the West, twisters and storms and so on. Finally, there's a moral to the whole story, represented by Dorothy's slippers. People have the power to solve their own problems, and they shouldn't rely on the federal government. And that's what a lot of literary scholars believe The Wizard of Oz means. They never have said what the dog Toto stood for. In our countdown, Toto stands for a top band from L.A. with a song at number 27 this week called Pamela. Pamela by Toto, following that top 40 brick road, up 4 notches to number 27 this week. 10th top 40 hit for the veteran band from L.A.
I'm Casey Kasem. We're on our way to this week's number one song on the adult contemporary chart. Now, here's the song that was number one on the pop chart 14 years ago this week, back in 1982. It's by Toto, a 6-man band whose members started out as studio musicians. Separately, they had worked with acts like Sonny and Cher, Steely Dan, Elton John, Boz Scaggs, and Jackson Brown. This is Toto with their number one smash, Rosanna. 14 years ago this week, back in 1982, that was the number one song on the pop chart, Rosanna by Toto. Now on with this week's countdown.
Casey's Countdown.